This is the last part of a series on XGBoost. In this video, we'll take a look at the sparsity-aware split finding algorithm. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English, and my voice was produced in AI text-to-speech. Chapter 3 of the XGBoost paper introduces split finding algorithms. Approximate algorithm, weighted quantile sketch algorithm, and sparsity-aware algorithm are presented. We've looked at these algorithms in the last two videos. And in this video, we'll look at the sparsity-aware algorithm. We will then use the XGBoost library to analyze Santander Bank's customer dataset. Let's take a look at the section 3.4 of the XGBoost paper. In many real-world problems, it is quite common for the input X to be sparse. There are multiple possible causes for sparsity. The first is that there are missing values in the data. The second is there are frequent zero entries in the statistics. The third is there are artifacts of feature engineering, such as one-hot encoding. It is important to make the algorithm aware of the sparsity pattern in the data. We need to solve this problem. This is the sparsity-aware split finding algorithm presented in this paper. Below is part of Santander customer dataset. You can see there are a lot of zeros. Now, let's look at this algorithm step by step. When splitting a node, only non-missing or non-zero values, i.e. normal data, are used to find the optimal split point. Find the split point using only non-zero values in the data on the left. Let's consider these zeros here as missing values. Next, calculate the gain when assigning missing values to the left, and calculate another gain when assigning missing values to the right. Then, we assign the missing values to the side with the larger gain. This is the default direction for that split. The optimal default directions are learned from the data. For the first split in the tree below, the default direction is left. And for this split, the default direction is right. In the prediction stage, when predicting test data, missing values in the test data are assigned to the default direction of each node. When we feed the test data into this tree, missing values are assigned to the left in the first split and to the right in the second split. This allows us to predict the test data that contains missing values. This is the figure 4 of the paper. Algorithm 3 presented in section 3.4 is as follows. The uppercase I represents the data points on the current node. The uppercase IK represents kth feature values of normal data, excluding missing values. And M is the number of features. First, we calculate the G and H of the current node. Then, we read through the features one by one to find the best one. Next, assign all missing values to the right node. And we calculate the gain for this split. Next, assign all missing values to the left node. Then we calculate another gain for this split. Finally, set the larger of these two gains as the default direction. If the gain is greater when assigned to the left, set the default direction to left. All missing values can be assigned to the left node, default direction. This is the sparsity-aware split finding algorithm. Now let's analyze the Santander customer data using the XGBoost library. This is the data requested by Santander Bank for the Kaggle contest. The number of data points is 76,020, and the number of features is 370. Our goal is to predict the target customer satisfaction. The target of 1 means that the customer is dissatisfied, and the target of 0 means that the customer is satisfied. The target values are mostly 0 over 90%, and some are 1. This data is very sparse. That means it contains a lot of zeros. Now let's write code to analyze this data. Let's use the XGBC classifier from the XGBoost library. First, we read the stored data. And then we simply do some pre-processing. The var3 feature contains several invalid values, so we change them to 2, which is the most common value in that feature. And we deleted the ID column. Separate the dataset into features and targets, and split them into the training and test data. The number of boost trees is set to 200, and the depth of each tree is set to 5. Set the eta, lambda, and gamma to these values, and set the epsilon to 0.03 to be used for weighted quantile sketch. Create a model using the XGBoost classifier. Set the basic parameters as follows, and set the missing value for sparsity aware to 0. The many zeros seen on the previous page are considered missing values. We then perform row and column subsampling as we did with stochastic gradient boosting. Set both sampling rates to 50%. The col sample binode parameter performs feature sampling for each split, the same as random forest. And as in the last video, the max bin and tree method are set as follows. These are for the weighted quantile sketch. Fit this model to the training data. And we predict the test data and measure the model's performance. The performance is measured by ROC AUC. The result is like this. The AUC score is 0.834. We briefly analyzed this data using XGB classifier. For your information, there are 3 modes of column sampling: col sample by tree, col sample by level, and col sample binode. The by tree samples the feature in advance and creates a tree using the selected features. In the next round, the tree is built from the newly sampled features. The bi-level samples the feature on each level of the tree and splits nodes using the selected features. On the next level, newly samples the feature. The binode performs feature sampling each time a node is split. Use the new sampled features for this split. The binode is the method used in random forest. We used binode here. Let's try to run this code. The AUC score is 0.8276. Run this one more time. This time it came out as 0.8340. So far, we have looked at all of XGBoost's content through a total of 9 videos. There are many proposals in the XGBoost paper, but we only looked at the parts related to machine learning algorithms. In addition to this, various methods are proposed to effectively analyze the large amounts of data. Since this part is closer to computer science than machine learning, I will omit the explanation of this part.